Hey guys, Sydni here, and in today's video, we are going to talk about when is the right time to use an iron remover on your paint. With me today, I have Mr. Dave Phillips, who is the chemist for P&S Detail Products. What do I do to decontaminate my car? Let's dive into that.
The reason you always wanted to decontaminate your car in the past was because you were going to do something to it after. You would decontaminate your car before you polished it. Mm-hmm. You would decontaminate your car before you waxed it. But that's still remaining true today because you still want to decontaminate your car, which is basically removing the bumps, in my case, so that your, say, your instant detailer or your ceramic product will work better on the surface. It's clean. It's a clean surface to work with.
A lot of times nowadays, coatings, ceramic coatings, can get what we call clogged. And really what that means is just the pores of it is blocked by contamination, making people think that the coating is not doing its job, whether it be with hydrophobics or even gloss and shine. Now decontaminating your paint has become a very useful service for detailers. Other than prepping for a detail, how often should we do it? And then we'll go into what products we should use.
Right, I think it partly depends how often you should do it is which type of decontamination you're going to do. Anytime you feel the surface of your car and it feels like it's got rough spots on it, that's a good time to decontaminate your car. Now that depends a lot on how you take care of your car. If your car's inside, you're certainly not gonna have to decontaminate your car every time.
Yeah.
But if you've got a car sitting out under a tree, then perhaps sections of your car you'll have to decontaminate more often, and the type of decontamination you might want to use to do that.
Yeah, so let's break into those. So first things first, everybody knows what an iron remover is. So obviously our product is called Iron Buster, great iron remover.
Typically just using an iron remover is only doing one job, one function of decontaminating your paint.
What we have found is obviously in contamination on the paint, it's really more prevalent the other environmental fallout. A lot of stuff that comes up off the street, but also out of the air, maybe
fallout,
off trees.
Out of the air.
Yeah.
Yep.
And so iron remover actually isn't going to remove all of those fallouts.
Right.
So we have crystal wash.
Crystal wash. So where iron remover has one purpose, crystal wash actually moves quite a lot of the surface contamination, including, you know, hard water, some hard water materials. And the way it works is you've got a weak organic acid and a chelate, which they're basically the same material, but the weak organic acid helps break that loose. The chelate helps grab hold of it. In the case of crystal wash, you also, if you let it dry, has a mechanical action of actually kind of breaking some things loose.
So yeah.
Whereas, you know, iron remover is doing one thing, crystal wash is doing the other things, but contrary, crystal wash is not a great iron remover.
Right.
So each one has its advantages and disadvantages.
Yeah. So then if somebody was decontaminating their paint, how often should one worry about it? I know as a detailer, I'm seeing my customers' cars once a year, and of course I decontaminate them when they come in once a year. If someone's doing this at home, do they need to do it every wash?
No, no, for sure not with crystal wash or iron remover. Yeah. Now, the other one we haven't gotten to is, you know,
clay towels. Yep, we have three options here. These are all exactly the same. They all are a fine grade synthetic clay. All of these are not going to mar the surface. They're gonna be very safe, durable. This is different than traditional clay. Even though they're called fine grade, it's going to do a good amount of cleaning. If you have really heavy buildup, really heavy contamination, you may need to go to a traditional clay bar. Most of the time, synthetic clay is going to do a really good job.
Right, on your maintenance, situation.
Right.
You know, I mean, you can just go feel the surface of your car after you're done washing it. If it feels like it's got bumps on it, then you can quickly do, you know, the clay scrubber where you need it.
For me in my shop, when I'm doing it, if I'm gonna be using crystal wash on that particular car, I spray the crystal wash because crystal wash works best on a dry car.
Right.
Let it do its thing, wash it, and then I clay it.
That's also an option for you if you don't want it, or you don't have a more heavy duty option for a clay. The crystal wash is gonna remove 90%.
Yeah.
Of the bumps already.
And that's why I start with the crystal washes, because I want to get the majority of that stuff off because it shortens my clay time. Now, if I'm using Iron Buster, then I would wash clay first and then use the Iron Buster.
These are not necessary to use every time. Usually you just don't have enough stuff stuck to the surface that you would need crystal wash. So these are, you know, when you need it, and I'm thinking 3 months, six months.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, not every time.
Let's jump into, we need to grab some gloves, and then we're gonna jump into how to use these products on the surface. each of these products has their own application method, dwell time, all that kind of good stuff. So we're gonna go through that real quick. I'm gonna start on this half of the car with Crystal Wash. So a couple things to note on this. This can go on most surfaces. The only one that I would avoid would be the front windshield. The glass just tends to be a little bit different on the front windshield. It could leave a spot, it doesn't generally, but I like to avoid that. It is easily corrected if you do get some overspray on, but so I'm gonna avoid the front windshield. I'm gonna spray it on this fender, and I'm actually gonna hit the wheel too. This is a great wheel cleaner. So we're gonna do right here. I would say that when working indoors like this, there is a dwell time, right, for the crystallization of this product. So one of the cool attributes of this product is we're gonna spray it on a dry surface, we're gonna let it set, and it's actually going to dry on the surface, and it's gonna look like little broken up diamond crystals. It's really cool. We do have to remember this is a mild acid, but it's not like using wheel acid. And then Dave is going to show us Iron Buster.
Yeah, so your other option when you're decontaminating, in this case, we're gonna use Iron Buster. So whereas Crystal Wash hopefully will remove a bunch more of the bumps and stuff, this is just gonna do the iron.
And so Iron Buster, like most iron removers, is gonna be more of a reactive product to the iron, right? It's actually going to show us exactly where that iron is. Now there is, what would you say the working time is that you wanna kinda give it the full dwell? Just 2-3 minutes?
Yeah, I like at least 2 minutes.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You definitely wanna do it on a cooler surface.
We are working indoors right now, so we have a little bit longer working time. If you are out in your driveway or you're a mobile detailer, you're gonna be working faster. So just keep that in mind. As the air dries both of these products, you don't necessarily want Iron Buster to dry. We do want Crystal Wash to dry. So just watch your dwell times and, you know, if the product's drying out, whatnot. But this one, we're gonna let it work. It's gonna turn purple. It's gonna show us all the iron.
So in this case, what it's actually, the color it's turning is actually a reaction with iron on the surface. So you're seeing it pull and change the iron. And it turns purple.
I have a feeling in this case, the Crystal Wash is actually gonna pull off a lot more of that contamination than the Iron Buster. But there is iron present, but what I think is interesting is that the majority of it is not iron. We can see the purple starting to bleed, but you know, there's some, it's not terrible. Not terrible.
Pretty minimal, but you can see where they are. I mean, these are all little dots of iron. So you're probably going to see more iron in general on a wheel.
Sure.
Because you have the brakes.
Yeah.
And the calipers, and they're kind of spitting out iron as you use them.
Yep. Now over here, I don't know if we can see this on camera in this light, but this has dried on the surface. And so we do actually see where it has not really given it a crust, but it's definitely dried on the surface and it's like crystallized. It's now dried on the contamination, right? And it breaks it away,
right,
making it physically unable to stay attached.
As the crystals form, they change their shape a little bit. And so if they're bumped up next to one of those bumps, they just push on it a
yeah.
little bit.
Yep. Okay, so now at this point, what we would do is we will rinse it down, wash it with our soap, and then we'll go back and do the clay. Now, like we said in the beginning though, because we wanted to show you the side-by-side, normally if you were planning on using an iron remover, you would clay before the iron remover, but for the sake of this video, we're gonna clay just this part after we get done washing it. So I'm gonna grab the pressure washer and we'll get this rinsed off. We rinsed off our Crystal Wash and our Iron Buster, and then I quickly washed the section that I want to clay, because you would always wanna wash before you clay to get the rest of the dirt off. So let's talk about clay real fast. You will use whatever method that your next step in your detail, paint correction, whatever you're gonna be doing from here on out. So in this case, if we're doing a paint correction, I'm just gonna use the clay scrubber and some paint gloss, which is what we use as our clay lube. But you can also jump right into if you're doing like the wash clay seal process. I love to still use Crystal Wash ahead of time just to extra get that contamination off there. You could be heading into a paint correction and ceramic coating. And so this is just gonna show you how to do the clay in your next prep process from here. We will just put the clay lube on the surface. Now, let's talk about real quick what we're noticing from the surface after we did the Crystal Wash and the Iron Buster. So we saw them both react. When we feel the vehicle, we still definitely feel kind of those bumps, right? So when I hit this, it's actually going to sound like sandpaper. And so what's nice about this is as we're moving the clay across the surface, you can hear the contamination break free, and it's almost like the clay goes silent, which is really nice. So you're just going to make sure you use plenty of lube, go back and forth over the surface until you don't feel those large chunks anymore. We're just using a clay lube for this because we're gonna jump into a different process later on this vehicle, and we're just trying to get those bumps so that it feels nice and smooth. And then you can go back and rinse, or you can just go straight to drying from this process. Now that we have tested and completed what each step does, we've obviously identified that this vehicle needs all of the steps. So we are going to spray crystal wash on the vehicle dry. We're gonna give it time to dwell, let it do its thing, and then we're gonna rinse that off. We're gonna go straight into our contact wash, which we're using frostbite soap today, and then we will rinse the vehicle again. Then we will go straight into the clay, getting that heavier contamination, all the, you know, the bumps that we feel, we're gonna get those off the surface. Then we will rinse it and go straight in with the iron buster so that this gives a clean surface that the iron buster can do the most amount of work. And then we'll rinse that off and we'll be ready to dry.
Okay, we better get working.
Now that we have the car all washed and decontaminated, it looks so much better. But real quick, I have to show you guys, we heard how it sounded like sandpaper earlier up on the door. So I wanted to show you what it should sound like after you're done claying. And if you can hear that, which is basically nothing, that means that we were able to get all of that hard contamination that was stuck on the surface off.
How often should we do this?
Depending on how your car lives is really gonna be the answer to that question. So maybe every 6 months to a year, depending if it's just a daily driver, lives a fairly normal life, stays in the garage, maybe once a year, you know, go through this process. You may wanna clay a little bit more often because that's kind of the part that you notice that grabs onto dirt. This particular car, given the fact that it is a drift car, it sees a lot of track time. This one's gonna need it a little bit more often, like every 3 to 6 months. But the point is that you don't need to do it every single wash. That's a little bit overkill, and it's just adding aggression to the surface that isn't necessary. I hope this helped answer the question of when is the right time to use an iron remover. Now, while the car's still wet and I have Dave here, we have a couple other products that I need to test before we drive this car. But if you have any questions, drop them in the comment section below, and we'll catch you next time.